had a lump in my neck, in the collarbone here, and I had to go down for some scripts. So I just mentioned it to the doctor casually. He sent me for an X-ray. It came back and he said, I think I'd like a scan. So I had the scan and then I was straight off to the specialist.
Well, when I was diagnosed, which took a while in the Sale Hospital, and then someone had a good idea that it'd be to X-ray my chest. Well, there was the cancer, of course. Well, then they had to find a way of getting into it, and that was difficult, but they did a biopsy, but it took about 2 or 3 weeks before they discovered what it was.
With lung cancer, we're often the first specialist to see a patient at a time when a mass or a nodule has been detected on a chest X-ray or other symptoms that have occurred that are suspicious of lung cancer. And our initial role is to take a history and examine the patient and to order further diagnostic tests. And one of those tests is bronchoscopy, which is a thin telescope that's passed through the nose or mouth. And respiratory physicians perform that test. And we also coordinate the other tests. And we're often the people who, in fact, establish the diagnosis and break the bad news of lung cancer. But as part of that initial assessment, there's also further tests that need to be done, because in general, there's much that can be done to manage lung cancer. And those further initial assessments include respiratory function tests to measure the strength of the lungs. In some cases, we do an exercise test, again, to get a more complete idea of the fitness of a patient. And the reason for doing these tests is to understand how much treatment can be tolerated by a patient, both in terms of surgery and radiotherapy, in some cases chemotherapy.
I was working and I got this rash on my face. I thought it was a wall rash. I work with wall. So I went to my GP. He took a blood test. Then I had an X-ray. Then I had a CAT scan. And that's how he found out that I had lung cancer.
So lung cancer is a cancer that grows from cells within a person's lung. And lung cancer is actually one of the most common types of cancer in both males and females in Australia as well as around the world. And there are different types of lung cancer. They're not all the same cancer. For example, there's a type of cancer called small cell lung cancer. And this is not a small cancer, as you might expect from the name, but it means that when the cancer is looked at under the microscope, that the individual cells that make up the lump of the cancer are very small. There's another broad category of lung cancer called non-small cell lung cancer, and this is actually the most common type of lung cancer. And within that, there are various subtypes of lung cancer that people might hear described, such as adenocarcinoma or squamous cell carcinoma. And the third broad category is mesothelioma, and this is a type of cancer that tends to grow around the outside of the lung in patients who have been previously exposed to asbestos. And it's really important that we try to define as precisely as possible what type of cancer the person has, because the different types of lung cancer will need different types of treatment.
So they sent me to the hospital and they took tests, then biopsies. And then all within a month I was in an operator, they took a quarter of my lung off.